This DIY spray is identical to Max Fix Plus. Ignore the color, ignore the weird bottle, ignore the lack of branding. This is Max Fix Plus. Hi everyone, I'm Elise, and in this series, I try and recreate popular hair and skincare products. Let's go for the ingredients because you're going to be surprised at just how simple this is to make. The first ingredient in Max Fix Plus is water. Regular water probably makes up around 90% of Fix Plus. Then we have a couple humectants that attract water to your skin. First up is glycerin, which I pretty much use in every DIY. But the second one is butylene glycol. Glycols are like the upgraded version of glycerin. They're excellent moisturizers, but they also work to stabilize the setting spray. This is primarily a hydrating spray, and that's reflected in the first few ingredients. Now here's where things get a little more interesting, as we have a bunch of plant extracts. Cucumber extract, chamomile extract, and green tea extract. All three of those extracts are soothing and anti-inflammatory, but they each have their own unique benefits for your skin. Cucumber extract instantly cools the skin and reduces swelling. Chamomile extract is amazing for soothing dry, irritated, and sensitive skin. While green tea extract improves the look of your skin, increasing elasticity, evening complexion, and reducing the appearance of damage. We also have vitamin E oil, which is a great antioxidant for the skin. And next we have caffeine. Caffeine has a tightening or smoothing effect on the skin, making it great to use in products like primers. But out of all the ingredients listed so far, you're most likely to experience irritation with something like caffeine. Similar to that of witch hazel, if you do have sensitive skin, it's probably an ingredient to bear in mind. It also lists pamphenol and arginine. Now these ingredients are responsible for that thin layer that you might feel on the surface of your skin when you spray Fix Plus. That film traps moisture into your skin, keeping it hydrated for longer periods of time. And we were doing so well until we get to these next few ingredients. So we have PEG hydrogenated castor oil, and we also have PPG 26 Butef. Now those two ingredients work together in order to mix perfume into this formula. And lastly, we have some preservatives to keep this from going moldy. So we can essentially boil down Max Fix Plus to water with some botanical extracts and vitamins added. If you were willing to forego adding in unnecessary perfume, then Max Fix Plus would actually be an all-natural formula, making it super easy to make at home yourself. And I'll show you how to do that right now.
You can get the free full written recipe along with more information on ingredients over at wholeelise.com. There's also a customizable formula calculator, helping you to convert measurements and scaling. Once you've measured out all the ingredients, pour the glycerin and butylene glycol into the water. Add in the extracts from earlier, cucumber, chamomile, and green tea. This is also what gives our DIY Max Fix Plus its color. It's completely normal for natural extracts to have different colors, and I actually prefer the golden hue that it gives this makeup and refresher spray. After that, add in the vitamin B5, also known as pamphenol. I wasn't able to get a hold of caffeine and arginine, but seeing as green tea is naturally high in caffeine, you'll still receive a lot of the benefits.
Because Max Fix Plus is essentially a toner or face spray, you can actually customize this recipe to include your favorite ingredients. Hyaluronic acid is pretty popular at the moment, but you could also use something like collagen or silk proteins or any other active ingredients that you know work really well with your skin.
To preserve, use your favorite broad spectrum preservative, making sure to follow along with the manufacturer's recommended usage rates. And then mix thoroughly until combined. You should have this crystal clear golden spray that has so many applications in your skincare. For a container, I'd recommend using a fine mist spray bottle. As this can be used to set makeup, it's important to make sure that it evenly coats your skin and doesn't leave large water droplets. I'm sure you've experienced just how annoying it is to use a spray that doesn't have a proper nozzle. This really affects how well it works, so don't skimp out on the bottle. You should be able to achieve this delicate mist that is super fine and feels fluffy on the skin.
You can use this DIY Fix Plus as a primer before applying your makeup, or to lightly set or refresh your makeup throughout the day. It works exactly like the original. To make your own DIY Fix Plus, follow the links in the description box below, or you can visit wholeelise.com and subscribe for even more skin and hair care tutorials.